if you listen to your son or anyone, then he'd tell you that he'd rather live here.
Stop putting your feelings about me onto Henry.
He tells me he likes it better here.
He tells you because he knows it's what you want to hear.
He tells me you're on the phone all the time. You don't even play with him.
Because I'm going through a divorce in LA and trying to direct a play in New York, which closed because I wasn't there.
One of the reasons this argument in writer and director Noah Baumbach's new movie, Marriage Story, is so intense is because he choreographs it almost like an action fight scene. While characters in his films are usually only attacking each other with their words, they often move through physical space in a way that complements the conflict. We don't just hear their words, but see on screen as characters attack, defend themselves, and try to back away. The setting for this scene is fairly simple. Two characters sit down to talk through their issues in a last-ditch effort to work out their divorce on their own. But over this 6-minute argument, Baumbach uses blocking and character movement throughout the entire apartment to bring their conflict to life on the screen.
I don't know how to start.
Do you understand why I want to stay in LA?
No.
These three shots show us the major arc of the fight. Charlie and Nicole start on even footing. Charlie tries to leave the fight, and finally he goes too far, regretting what he said. There are 5 major positions, and the 4 shifts between these 5 positions mark shifts in the topic of conversation. The first move, from position 1 in the living room, rotating 180 degrees to position 2 in the kitchen, marks the shift from discussing why Nicole wants to live in LA, a big issue in their divorce.
The only reason we didn't live here is because you can't imagine desires other than your own, unless they're forced on you.
Okay.
To talking about the lawyers and the divorce itself.
So what do we do?
I don't know.
Nora says there's no coming back from this.
As the conversation shifts from current issues they are facing in the divorce.
Let's just both agree both of our lawyers said shitty stuff about both of us.
Nora was worse.
Jay called me an alcoholic.
Pulled the rug out from under me and you're putting me through hell.
To past conflicts in their marriage.
You put me through hell during our marriage.
Oh, is that what that was? Hell?
The line of action moves again, turning 90 degrees from position 2 in the kitchen to position 3 in the living room and Henry's bedroom.
What's best for him?
Oh, well, I was wondering when you'd get around to Henry and what he actually wants.
The move into their son Henry's bedroom is also timed as the discussion shifts to him and the couple's parenting. The argument escalates as they go from making indirect accusations.
And you're like my father. You're also like my mother. You're all the bad things about all of these people.
To more direct personal attacks against each other. And they move again, rotating another 90 degrees from position 3 to position 4 in the living room and dining room. In this moment, you can really see how the shift in conversation is precisely timed to match the character's movement.
You're all the bad things about all of these people. But mostly your mother. When we would lie in bed together, sometimes I would look at you and see her and just feel so gross.
I felt repulsed when you touched me.
You're a slob.
As the argument shifts to Charlie's affair, he moves around Nicole from the dining room to the living room, almost 180 degrees from position 4 to position 5, where the argument will end.
You always made me aware of what I was doing wrong, how I was falling short. Life with you was joyless.
What, so then you had to go and fuck someone
else? You shouldn't be upset that I fucked her! You should be upset that I had a laugh with her!
We stay in this orientation as things continue to escalate until they boil over and we end up here. The changes in position subconsciously mark for the viewer changes in topic, and we see the characters literally go around in circles as their argument goes around in circles, never resolving anything, just spinning further and further out of control. Along the lines of action in each of the 5 positions, there are also horizontal movements or smaller adjustments to mark the escalation of conflict within each topic. In the first position, Nicole stands up and changes her angle of attack as she tries a different, more aggressive approach to getting Charlie to understand why she wants to stay in LA.
My work is here now. My family is here.
In the second position, Nicole pushes in closer as conflict escalates.
How could you ever say those things about me?
Jay said them about me too.
In the third position, we see several escalations and de-escalations. There's a push and pull on screen as they escalate from criticizing each other's parenting to using their own parents as weapons of criticism against each other.
Do not compare me to my father.
I didn't compare you to him. I said you were acting like him.
You're exactly like your mother.
In this scene from another of Noah Baumbach's films, the Meyerowitz story's New and Selected.
Thought you were doing the right thing.
You would have stayed.
Probably would have, yeah, but I would have felt bad about it.
We can see the same horizontal push and pull along a line of action used as this argument escalates and de-escalates. At first, Danny is trying to escape and Matt isn't letting him.
But it's a good lesson. Dad can take care of himself. You have to take care of yourself.
No, he can't, Matt. That's why he's where he is now.
Later, the tables turn and Matt is trying to escape while Danny won't let him.
I can understand that.
Can you? Because my feeling about you is you can't. It's not your fault. But like Dad, you make me feel really bad about myself.
As one brother gains the upper hand in the argument, the other wants out, the back and forth, push and pull, rise and fall of conflict becomes visible on screen. Blocking like this doesn't just illustrate changes in the flow of the argument, it can also reveal emotional subtext. You might notice in these shifts between positions that Charlie is the one trying to leave, moving away from the conversation, while Nicole is usually the one pushing in, bringing up new topics, and never letting him back out. This pattern fits the character's position in the overall conflict of the film. Charlie wants to maintain the status quo. He doesn't want to engage in a conversation that involves understanding why Nicole wants something different.
It's not what I want. I mean, it's what I want, but it's what was.
Nicole wants a better life for herself and is having to push against Charlie's desires with the divorce to get that.
You remember that summer I visited Dad on Martha's Vineyard?
In another scene from the Meyerowitz stories, Jean tells her brothers about abuse she was the victim of as a child.
When I arrived, nobody met me. I hitchhiked to the other side of the island.
Her emotional discomfort and desire to distance herself from the conversation is visually apparent through her movement away from them, placing trees as barriers between herself and them. Back with the brothers fighting in the lawn, once neither brother is trying to escape, the clash turns into an actual fight. In Marriage Story, Charlie becomes cornered. With nowhere else to escape, to de-escalate, he pushes against the wall. And when Nicole pushes again after this,
"Are you kidding me?"
he lashes out in the worst way he can.
"I'd hope you'd get an illness and then get hit by a car and die!"
And we see one of the reasons why Charlie wanted so badly out of this conversation. He was afraid he'd be pushed too far and say something he didn't want to say. Without his hesitation that we see expressed through blocking, his outburst would be less sympathetic. It's not Nicole's fault that he said these things he shouldn't have and he should take the full blame as a character, but we can understand that he at least didn't want to, or that he was trying to escape and avoid things going this far, not wanting to lose control. In this way, the blocking in the scene is actually vital to the scene successfully communicating the emotional subtext. And this physicality that Baumbach brings to these scenes just makes them that much more engaging and visually interesting. Combine it with performance, editing, and cinematography, and all these things work together to make the scene resonate with viewers.